item on the agenda is members code of conduct, declarations of interest. Are there any declarations of interest in the members? No? Okay, thank you. Okay. Minutes of the last meeting have been printed and published. And the matter called in, of course, will be reported in the meeting. It's agreed that they are approved and adopted. Outset with this, can I just explain, just so people are clear. Cabinet are asked to note that the Wirral Council plan is a final draft, awaiting final comments for amendment before full council. The plan, although a 5-year plan, has clear deliverables for this year, 2019-20. By agreeing this, it will enable the council to begin shape the future partnership plan. We will seek views of our partners and stakeholders over the coming months. Okay, so we've just set out a couple of comments on the plan itself. It sets out, of course, our ambitions for residents, the residents we represent in the year ahead and beyond. Those issues that residents contact us on as elected members on a regular basis, the masses that we have determined to tackle to improve the quality of life for our constituents. Issues like good work and street lights, making sure they are repaired, safer streets, streets that are kept clean, roads in a great condition, waste bins emptied on a regular basis, fly tipping tackled, are just some of those issues that residents expect and rightly demand. This plan will ensure residents hold us to account over the next year and beyond to deliver it. It is grounded in reality. It is based on what residents have told us, every member of this council, based on a realistic, achievable goal to improve the quality of life for residents in the wards we all represent. There are within it, of course, a number of key outcomes. As you can see, a prosperous, inclusive economy, where local people get good jobs and achieve their aspirations. Clean and green and water, which celebrates, protects and improves our environment and urgently tackles the environment's emergency. Brighter futures for our young people and families, regardless of their background or where they live. Safe, vibrant communities where people want to live and raise their families. Services which help people live happy, healthy, independent and active lives, with public services there to support them when they need it. I recently attended the Council Leadership Conference and stressed to them all the importance of putting residents at the heart of everything we do and going that extra mile to help solve issues no matter how big or how small. And it was not within this section to help find the person that can take action on behalf of that resident that comes to them. Our staff are fantastic and go to great lengths, we know, to do this every year and every day, should I say. That needs to be the norm right across this council. And this plan shows a route map and a determination to achieve that. Changing the culture and the way we deliver our services are at the heart of this plan. And I ask you all to get behind it to ensure we deliver great services for the residents of this wonderful borough of ours. to plan, as I've said, is grounded in reality. It's tackling the issues that residents want tackled. We're looking at the ways to deliver it. We're looking at changing the ways we deliver it. So residents, when we get hold of the council or the councillors, to make it easy for them. Okay. Any comments? Chris?
Thank you, Chair. I've been involved from the start with the little 2020 pledges, and I think what we've really built up all that time has been the partnership working. I think we were previous to that all working in our own little silos, and I've got three pledges, and I think the difference now in the way that we work with our health partners and our providers has made a massive difference, and I really would like to see exactly what we have achieved at the end of the 2020 pledges. The number of hours I've spent working on the three has probably been unbelievable over the last 4.5 years, and I think they've really formed a good basis for a new plan. I'm really glad to see that the public consultation will be starting shortly, and I think that is really important. And getting the public actually involved and telling us what they want us to do and us carrying out those wishes is really important.
Okay, thank you, Chris. Okay, any other comments? Councillor Williamson.
Thank you, Pat. Yeah, so firstly, I'd like to say thanks to those for all the hard work she's done on this. And also, I'm really pleased to see that an inclusive and community-based local economy strategy is going on within our local plan. I think we will maybe discuss later on about the community plan, which also ties in very much with that strategy. You know, we recognise as a council that mainstream economics have let people down here in the borough. And so we are taking part ourselves, we're really proactive in promoting the more community wealth building oriented strategy. So I'm really, really pleased to see that figure in the roadmap.
The comments? Councillor Leech.
Thanks, Chair. As Christine said, I think the 2020 pledges have given us a real base to work in partnership. On the doorstep, we heard from a number of people that they feel their voices have not been heard, that they've still got issues with roads, street lights, etc. And I just think that this plan is a real step change to listen to people's voices.
Any other comments? Okay, can I ask that members agree the contents of the Wirral Council's plan set up appendix 1 to this report and refer to full council on the 14th of October? Mindful of what I said at the start of the meeting. So we propose, Rita?
Chair, just to be clear, so this is the final draft, so there will be amendments. So I'm going to propose that based on that is the final draft.
Yeah. Okay. Seconded.
That
agreed?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, if you missed me at the start of the meeting, I should mention in terms of apologies, Councillor G. Manderson will be with us this morning. Okay, item 5, Public Health Annual Report 2019, Community Papers, 31 to 60, available for you. Councillor Jones.
Thank you very much, Pat. It's my great pleasure to bring the sixth Public Health Annual Report to Cabinet since Public Health moved back to the Council. The Public Health Annual Report is the independent annual report of the Director of Public Health and is a statutory requirement, and I'd really like to thank Julie Webster and her team for all the hard work they put into it. This year, the title of the report is Creative Communities, which ties in beautifully really with Wirral being the very culture of the Liverpool City region. And we wanted to see a legacy from that year as the very culture, which would impact on health, on well-being going on into the future. The case studies in the report show what impact cultural activities can actually have, and I think, you know, so far the Lurie culture has been such a fantastic, which I'm sure Chris will perhaps say something about, but the number of people who've been brought together and looking at sort of social isolation and encouraging people to look after their own health and well-being has already, I think, shown a big impact. 1,000 residents participated in the sofa session, talking about culture and creativity, and just literally talking about their own health and well-being. The report will hopefully inspire and energise individuals and encourage increased collaboration between different disciplines and organisations. The third sector have had a fantastic impact in a lot of this work. There's a beautiful tapestry. I don't know whether you've managed to see it as we run past it into Cabinet. But I'd really encourage everybody to go and have a look at the work that's been done. And some of the comments on there are so touching and meaningful. So I'd like to ask Cabinet to endorse the recommendations of the Public Health Annual Report 2019 and to support its publication.
Yes, that's very good. Thanks, Chris. It's really, really important, the health and well-being aspects of the work that you're doing and how the teams are working so well on this agenda. It's well reported, the positive impact that arts and creativity can have on individuals and communities for a whole range of reasons. I think as a society we're getting much more knowledgeable now that health impacts through art and culture and creativity. You know, going to do a painting class, sitting outdoors in the local park with others, doing young people who've got mental health issues, writing some lyrics that are about their lives that affect them. You know, there are many, many examples of very positive ways that creativity is used to help people with their mental health, with their social isolation, connecting better, celebrating the communities, getting pride in who they are, what they are, and also, you know, economically, the quality jobs in the future are going to be in the creative and digital sector. So, you know, thinking about that in terms of our young people, there's so much fantastic work that's starting to happen over the borough, as we know. We're getting towards the end of our amazing borough culture year. But it's still September, and I'll be talking later on at one of the meetings about that. We've achieved so much. There were over 30 people in Birkenhead Park for our first ever Food and Drink Festival, and the feedback has been incredible. People coming together, people being out in the fresh air, being in the park, listening to music, choir singing. Some of whose members were actually council officers who do that in their part time. So I went and sat down in a deck chair and there was and recognised somebody who works in the council, singing their heart out. So there were so many ways in which health impacted positively and creativity, so delighted. Just think we just need to be rebuilding on this now as a borough. So much more to come with these links. So thanks very much for everybody and their work on them.
Thank you, Justice Briggs. Any other comments? Propose the recommendation from our seconder.
Seconded.
Can you agree? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, item 6, scrutiny review of the statutory care plans of 861 to 94 of the main agenda. Councillor Usher, Tom.
Thank you, Chair. In a bit of a strange position today, because this piece of work was done whilst I was a chair of a scrutiny committee, and I made a number of recommendations to the cabinet member, who is now myself. So, a bit worrying. But just just to give you a bit of background on this, obviously in 2016 when we were found to be inadequate by Ofsted, there seemed to be a need to focus on the quality of care planning and central document that would inform professionals about child's life and the decisions around that child. We need to make sure of improvements and improvements at pace. So the Children and Families Scrutiny Committee set about a major piece of work that would run parallel to the improvement journey, and this was a piece of work that took over 10 months to complete. And I think just a couple of things that Ofsted picked up in 2016 is the case recording was sometimes poor, good practice wasn't good practice standards weren't clearly communicated. So we set about speaking to a number of professionals who would be involved in children care's lives and would be affected and would have a part to play in the effectiveness of care plans. Spoke to 30 officers, foster carers and service users, and we spoke to many young people as well about their experience of care. I think the report picks up a number of things, and because it was a long review and was purposely so, there are a number of things which we saw improved before the end of the review, which is obviously insurance, but it's also just kind of a bit of background as to why maybe the review doesn't pick up on a couple of things that were mentioned in earlier sessions. I think once Ofsted re-inspected children's services in 2019, they found that care, the services improved in all areas, and just specifically around care planning, they stated that children care now benefit from stronger systems of care planning, and that care planning meetings are held regularly. And support progress. So you can see a shift in the quality there. But there are a number of recommendations that this report gives, and funnily enough, I'm minded to accept all of them. And I just want to thank all the professionals, especially the Children Care Council, who gave up their time to really help us pick out some issues with the care planning process so that we could start to make some improvements at pace. So I'll recommend we accept all the recommendations and I'll leave it there for the questions. Okay. Thank you, Tom. Any questions for Tom? Okay.
Not a question, Chair, but just a comment. I believe that seems to be an awful lot of work that's gone into this, and I think it's a really good report.
Thank you very much, Councillor Liz. Yeah, it was a bit lengthy piece of work, and it's quite a large report. There are 19 recommendations overall, so it's picked up quite a substantial amount of things that we can improve upon.
Yes, similarly, Tom, I want to thank you for all the work you've done. I also want to thank your predecessor, all your colleague Bailey as well, and Paul, who is here. You know, we've done exceptionally well compared to where we were, and I'm pleased to see that you accept your own recommendations. That's always a good thing. So, if you provide us with regular updates on how what progress we're making on those recommendations, that would be really helpful.
7, approval of revised local development scheme for Wirral. Councillor Usher.
Thanks, Chair. This is a self-explanatory note. The local development scheme sets out the amended time change for the local plan. We are legally obliged to produce a local plan, which we are pressing ahead with to successfully deliver the local plan. Our members have been given them updates and briefing sessions as matters have progressed. This report sets out the detail for the new time frame, which is extremely tight. In line with the Secretary of State's letter to the Council in January 2019. The recommendation is that the Council is recommended to approve the adoption of the revised local development scheme attached to this report and to resolve that the revised scheme will come into effect on the day following the date that the Council resolution is passed.
Any questions? Can I just say, I'd like to congratulate Councillor Leech. I think I was doing an awful lot of hard work, put it mildly, it's gone on to this, along with the officers. I've attended numerous meetings over the last number of months, because it is one of the big priorities of this council, to get the local plan over the line, as they say. It's so important for so many reasons. We won't go into them all now, but as I say, I'd just like to congratulate all concerned to get us to this point. I think it's fair to say we are on course for the milestones and the deadline that we need to reach next year. Okay. We agree the recommendations. Can I have a proposal and seconded? I'm told by the lawyer that I must have a proposal and seconded. Proposal, Judith. Tell us seconded. I'll be going to agree that for you. Okay, number 8, Tramway Rovers Partner Agreements, pages 127. 52, the main agenda,
Councillor Williamson. Thanks, Chair. So, Tramway Rovers is our local football club. I'm sure we've all got some close ties, and one way or another, either ourselves or our families have. No, I've got family members that have season ticket holders, and they've stuck with them throughout. Tramway Rovers are more just a football club, though, aren't they? They're actually embedded in the heart of our community, and I know that they really deliver on the bottom of our public health outcomes. And they've done that for years, although I do think that since Mark's been there, he's absolutely accelerated his programme. He's adds a lot of social value to Borough. So this partnering agreement is a way of putting everything down, making things a little bit more sort of professional and formal between us and the club. I know Mark came to the scrutiny committee a few weeks ago and was really warmly received by members that attended, cross-party members. So I'd like to say, you know, that this for me signals our intention to go forward with Tramway Rovers and to continue working with them and to actually expand and grow our relationship with them. Just looking for you to agree with this report. Thank you.
Thanks, Janette, for the report. I think you can't underestimate really the amount of work that the club does do in the community. And in particular, I'd like to bring out the work that they do with children who have been excluded from other schools and the work that they've done with them and the attendance rate that they've had. It's quite phenomenal to think that 90% of our young people are actually completing the courses. And from the presentation that Mark Pallett actually gave to members, he was indicating that these people who didn't want to attend school were suddenly in the summer holidays saying, can't come in and do something because of IELTS. You know, so that's a complete and utter turnaround for me. And I think the work they're doing in the community is great. I think it's fantastic that we've now formalised this. Because there was a number of strands of work that Tramway Rovers were doing for the council, and I think this just brings it all together so it's clear, precise and transparent.
Any other questions?
decision, it was endorsed in the council programme to put £5 million into an investment in community bank, where we have partnered with Liverpool City Council and Preston City Council. What I'm asking today is agreement to draw down a small amount of that money to undertake a due diligence exercise, which will advise us on the case for a North West Community Bank. And due diligence provides intelligence by looking at the customer base, potential community reach. Risks can be more easily identified, quantified and mitigated when it comes to making bigger investments. I have no doubt that we will go on to make the final investment. We have already incorporated into North West Mutual now that the other two councils have just spoken about. I'm sure everyone can agree that there's a large section of our residents here that have been completely let down by high street banks. They're financially excluded, they don't have a branch to go to, often they can't get a bank account because they're on very low income. Banks are not in the business anymore of helping people, they're there simply to make money from them. And unfortunately a lot of our residents are not the kind of customers that they're interested in. So I would like to say that this bank for me is absolutely labour values in action. It will help those people who have been excluded from the mainstream. It will help small businesses and small traders, another part of our community wealth building strategy, so we can start to build wealth up from the grassroots. The bank will keep the profits on Wirral, so we will, not like any other high street bank which extracts profits from the borough, we will keep the profits here, they will be plowed back into the borough, and we will help people grow their businesses who are hitherto being unable to because they can't. The high street banks, despite being told by the government after the crash, are not lending. So this is an enormously progressive policy, one which I think we should all be really, really proud of. And I'm so happy that I'm leading on this. So the recommendation I would like Cabinet to agree is that we endorse the requirements for a North West Mutual Community Bank, and that we draw down from £5 million investments so we can undertake due diligence before we go on to the next stage.
Thanks, Councillor Leech.
Thanks, Janette. Due diligence is obviously very important and essential tool for moving forward on this very exciting project, and I agree with the recommendation.
Councillor Spriggs.
Thank you. Thanks, Janette. Yeah, always been supportive of this idea and been following how successful it's been as a programme up in Preston. So it's absolutely thrilling that we and Wirral are playing our part and doing something really innovative, aesthetic and exciting. There are so many young entrepreneurial, social entrepreneurial people coming forward now as part as a result of impact of Wirral of culture. People inspired to set up their own small creative businesses. In fact, I attended the Make Hamilton Grow party on Saturday night. There are 9 tenants already in the building, a local silversmith, a fine artist. These are all small businesses and sole traders. There are other people coming to me with other ideas about businesses they want to set up that are about giving back, that are about social good, that are creatively based. So there's a real synergy there between the community bank, culture and creativity, mental health, social well-being, social isolation. So really tremendous and well done. I'm looking forward to seeing what comes next.
Thank you, Councillor Jones.
Yeah, thanks very much for that. You actually missed out regeneration and growth there, Chris, in that list.
I'll leave that to you, Tony. That's your
point. Thanks ever so much. I actually fully endorse and support the recommendations. I think it's a first-class example of what I'd like to term new civil socialism. I think it's a long overdue, and I'm fully supportive. And I thank you very much for the hard work you've done, Janet.
Councillor
Gray.
Thank you.
Yeah,
life-changing for a lot of people, particularly some of our most vulnerable residents.
banks back to the Borough's high streets, because, you know, at a time when the high streets is really suffering beer time and time again, and people keep saying they need to change, they've got to do things differently, you know. I think this will help in so many ways, doing those things differently, as Chris said. A lot of high streets now are offering a lot more of the traditional shops and the traditional things that, you know, that we are used to. They're offering cultural and creative and digital services now as well. And having a high street bank there, I think, will really help in that way. And also the time when free-to-use ATMs are being removed from at least affluent areas, I think something like this has got to make such a big, big difference. And it is trailblazing for the world, perhaps, that helps. Councillor Williamson, I don't know if you've got something else to tell us.
In keeping with our sort of community wealth building and our social value, I'm really, really proud. I'm going to do Debbie the game bit here now. Here it is. This is an award that Rural Council won. These are actually, which is the Association of Public Sector Excellence, awarded us this a few weeks ago. Nikki, well done to you and your team. The way on this. Done earlier this month in APSE's National Service Awards, we won the Best Innovation and Demand Initiative. We beat off competition from several other councils. This award recognition is the highlight of an incredibly successful year for this programme. The council recommended that the National Social Value Awards, Oak Procurement Awards, and LGC Awards, demonstrating the invaluable contribution it's made to the lives of young people and the innovative programme developed by the council. This pioneering programme, with enormous long-term benefits, shows the council working with its supply chain, providing opportunities to disadvantaged young people through full-time work and apprenticeships. We've enabled young people to feel valued, supported, and optimistic about their future, and they've recognised the benefits of full-time employment. And I think this just ties in with Chris's report, Chris, with your comments. We're starting to see a fully developed strategy here around community wealth building, young people, what our role is as a council, and labour values embedded in all of this. So I wasn't there on this occasion. I have been previously there. We've had to do our Oscar face when we didn't win, so it was absolutely fantastic that we did win this time. Nikki, thank you so much to you and your team. Please take everyone's thanks back as well after today.
Stand there for an hour and look at the traffic, you'll know that anyone trying to cross the road could be considered to be taking their life in their hands. But going back to the report, it's a major part of the jigsaw, that particular infrastructure process. And it's actually sees the project moving on at a rate that that's really nice to say. Even before I was elected, there was talk about rural waters and the development of rural waters. It does seem to have been a long time coming. But now, looks like things are really starting to move. Wirral Water is the longest regeneration project, the largest regeneration project in the UK. And it's got the potential to create thousands of jobs, thousands of new homes. And I'd just like to conclude by saying I can't stress enough how important it is for my colleagues to support the recommendations. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Tony. Any comments?
Thank you, Pat. Yeah, I think it's really exciting at long last that we are actually moving on. And as a councillor for Seacombe, I've obviously got a bit of a vested interest as well. But I think, you know, seeing signs down there now that things are actually moving. And I think the fact that people will feel safer on roads, whether it's cycling or walking, will make a difference, because we know how dark it could be down there, and a little bit terrifying when you're going to work in the call centre or whatever, around to walk. So this is really good news, I think, all around, and it will be fantastic to see it actually coming back out to the ground.
That's what you
I think I'd just like to offer my congratulations to Tony and to the officers who worked really, really hard in unlocking some of these sites and moving them forward. You know, as Tony said, I was speaking to a resident recently who said, my child was two when this was being talked about. He's in high school now. So, so I think it's fantastic that this is now moving forward at a considerable pace. And I can't underestimate the work that our officers have put into this in unlocking the funds, and I'd just like to congratulate them.
Any other comments there? Councillor Wilson?
Thanks, Pat. Yeah, congratulations to both of you involved. When we look at Tower Road, between the two bridges we've been replacing in the past 5 years, obviously getting more investments in the infrastructure there. So that's a new scheme. Greening of the area, and provide a welcome face for businesses and people wants to really pay for it. And we look forward to seeing the finished product.
Thank you.
Nice to hear the words culture and art being mentioned again in your portfolio, Tony. But it really is important, because it is going to be what animates that area, and people that are spending money in the area, office work is going to be, going for a drink after work. It's all going to help our local economy, which is what we need in a local council.
Thank you very much. It's a very exciting project, and along with all the other big ticket issues and projects that we're doing, I think an awful lot of it is coming together. And it's coming together for one simple reason. I mean, we hear the words, do something to achieve a new way of working, but it is a new way of working. And I think the officers particularly and members have to be congratulated for that, because it makes such a big difference. As has been said, it's been around a long time with all business. Certainly, as far as I can recall, since 2006, 2007. So it's an awful long time, so you mentioned the Council Leech mentioned. So, the young child has now grown up, and we are where we are with Wirral Waters. But to actually see a number of projects actually going up, I think it's what is it, cranes in the sky, spades in the ground, we always talk about, don't we? And it's true, because that does change the mindset of people in no uncertain terms, because people equally lack confidence and do get cynical. But they don't see things happening, and they blame us. Not blame yourself, you'll blame us, and blame the officers, because we're there to make it happen on their behalf. And we don't forget either that the people who we represent are the most important in all of this, because what Janette's doing with the social value elements of it, of Community Bank, and all those elements is embedded into everything we do with regeneration and every aspect of what we do. And not least as well, with Liz's portfolio, green agenda, and what we're talking about time and time again. It's so important with the elements within this that's embedded, and it is embedded, is it not, in your cycle? because the old favourites are the best. Because you Brighton was the same in the early days. They always said it never, never happened. And we went for 10, 15, 20 years with the community down there. And it was a community-led regeneration project in the end to make it happen. And it's changed the face of it, both physically and also the mindsets of people down there. Also, a lot more's going to happen, and I was quite taken aback, I have to say, by the negative comments within the Echo over the last few days, saying that New Brighton's lost all its famous landmarks. New Brighton's coming back. There's a lot happening. There's a lot happening down there, and a lot more going to happen. And just like our big ticket projects with Wirral Waters and with the Wirral Growth Company, we are going to change and transform the face of Wirral like you've never seen, and we're actually moving on that now. So it's fantastic. Greens, and we're doing it. But we're doing it for the right reasons. We want to regenerate